watch me turn this around. Take the pain for my life. Walk the distance from fear forever. Watch me turn this around. Take the pain for my life. Walk the distance from fear forever. Watch me turn this around. Take the pain for my life. Walk the distance from fear forever. Watch me turn this around. Take the pain for my life. Walk the distance from fear forever. Watch me turn this around. Take the pain for my life. Walk the distance from fear forever.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time. Time has come. Grand final time, baby. Shawnee Poons, are you excited? Tell me your thoughts on this one. Infused versus Excess. As I said before the break, I don't know how to call this one, but hopefully you can.
Well, let's wait and see, because Excess have had a lot of time waiting between these matches. Infused have just got off a four-match series against Rift, taking it in a very great series of matches to watch. And, you have to wait and see how Excess prepare. Of course, in the history of these two teams in the past month, Excess very well, historically in a way, of course, took the game against Infused at the EU Open back in London. And that was a memorable series for all the right reasons, including trash talk, interviews, and a game five all the same. And who knows what's going to happen here, because if Infused manage to win this series, we're not done here tonight, because per loser bracket rules, we go on to a continuation. So away we go, Toby. This is where it gets very, very contentious now.
And that is, of course, something to highlight. If Infused do, in fact, win this best of five between them and Excess, due to how double elimination brackets work, they've come from the loser's bracket. We will see another best of five. But they have to get through the first one, folks. They are up against the French squad, the best team at the EU Open by far, Excess were, and it's Hydron who's going to open things up with a down.
Oh, and then Hydron a double down, but the first one is from Excess. These two physics get the kill as well, and that's going to make this very interesting, because they need to try and get more, but Infused coming off the bat strong, and they take the first round convincingly and immediately, and that's what they needed there, and that's a good start for them.
Nicely done indeed. They played aggressive at the snipe tower. Yet, Excess picked up the boom shot, but it didn't matter to Infuse. Of course, Hydron picked up the first down, and Infuse are off to a good start, of course. Looking east camera to begin with for this one, folks. It is going to be 1-0 to Infuse. Cast your eyes to the top left of the screen to see what they're doing for their opening strat. And it does seem like they're going to do 2-1 like Excess. They're on board with Phelps now. He's joining his teammate for the weapon side of the nade, and they are going to get it without much contention.
Grenade's out. From him, first one from Hydron again, on point for his team. And that's a boomshot pickup here for Infused. And they are mopping the floor with Excess at the moment. 2-0. And they're absolutely flying at the moment, Toby. Great stuff from them.
They are certainly bringing the pain right now. Only one kill, one down, and one revive to Excess's name. And I have to point it out, Shawnee, before I do forget. First place, folks, if you didn't know, gets £500 and TC. The Coalition swag and weapon skins, 200 for second place, so that's a big drop, and then only £100 for third place. Now, back to the action though. After I've highlighted that, it is 2-0 to Infuse. They are in the driver's seat, and it looks like they're going to use that to be aggressive. Ashy's going to get down. Hydron, the next one to follow, and D2 will pick up the kill. 4v2 now.
Yeah, big, big play from him. Felt's going to try and go in, but no. SS responded immediately. Three rounds to the blasted. Close to 30 seconds or less. These have been quick and concisive rounds from both teams. Obviously Infused in the driver's seat, but Excess responded in kind and looking to get back into this series. We have a game on our hands here, Toby.
Well. I'm going to put it out there. I've just been thinking to myself, Shawnee. I think Infused are going to get the continuation. Okay, I reckon judging from last match against Rift, that they're going to come away with the best of five win here. Ash leading the way. He's going to get a kill, but will get quickly taken out himself. 3v3 situation. Frags going in. Smoke is still there. And the boom shot is gone, Shawnee. I'm not sure where that's gone, actually.
Yeah, boom has disappeared. And they're going to have a fight here. Angels and his teammates having to, having to back up in that particular scenario. 3v3 at the moment. This is the most passive run we've had so far in terms of kills. So this is where we might get a bit of a slowdown here as both teams try and set up. And most likely Infused would want to get this boom shot considering they're on the right. Well, they're all pushed up for it, pretty much.
Yep. Very crafty play, though, by Team Infused. Phelpsy worked together with Hydron there to collect that boom shot, which was on the floor, making good use of the situation that the boom did rest on their side. Now, difficult task for Access, of course. If Infused do unleash the beast in the form of Craze with the sniper rifle, Hydron with the boom shot, this should be an Infused round.
Yeah, and we should wait and see. But with that boom respawning, it could work out very nicely for Hydron, of course, to try and use that to force Excess from making any sort of play on there right now. But at the moment, that boom will be coming up very shortly. If you're Excess, Toby, I mean, what's your approach here for this?
It's a very difficult approach of that, Shawnee. Craze actually rotated the sniper rifle to Arch as well, which is going to give protection to Boomshot, maybe a bit more so. Maybe a better sight line than the Snipe Tower would provide. And the boom shot in the form of Hydra in his position at the snipe tower. So they're going to prevent that push up there. And just like that, they have snuck away with the boom shot in hands of Phelpsy. And the advantage of Infuse just keeps stacking now this round.
Yeah, two booms in hand, Toby. You have to feel from a firepower perspective, this should work out very nicely for them. A minute and 40 to go on the timer. Time is kind of ticking, but they have the power weapons to make it work here. And Baghdad is probably the person who's going to make the push. But there you go. That is a kill here for Phelps on Dark Frag and a 3v2. It's looking better and better now for them as the Baghdad trying to go in. He didn't go down to that boom, but does go down to the melee. And Angel's on his own, and that should be a round win for Infused.
Yep, the power weapon control and map control has snowballed into this situation now. 3v1 down to Angels himself. Trying to hold the staircase, but remember, Infused will likely be sending a man on the back, and they are. Oh, Hydron. Hydron, what a nice kill that was. Spinning round after that wall run. It will be 3-1-2 Infused right now, Shawnee. Quite convincingly as well. These rounds have been nothing short of a speed run, it seemed, for Infused. Bar that one loss.
And away we go again, Toby. So this is looking very... This is the start Infused need. And remember, of course, if they do win this best of five series, we have another one if Infused do happen to win it. But goodness me, this is the best start they could have made. Excess right now, a really rattled sniper picked up in the hands of Infused.
Yep, boom shot though, picked up by Physics. His teammate is pushing through on the L car, still not down, but I say that he is now down and Phelps has secured that kill, but D2 fights back. And Craze gets a headshot on D2 as well. Kills are just popping off on the kill feed. Baghdad getting a double nade kill, and Craze will not be able to get out of that sniper tower alive with that sniper rifle in hand.
Good response there from XS, but of course they need another round to take us to round 7. And, well, with a match point already gone for Infused, they have another opportunity to do it, but pressure kind of creeping in a little bit. XS showing some fight. That's what they needed. And here we go into round 6 now.
So it's been a battle of shotguns so far, the archway, Shawnee. XS seemed to adapting somewhat, being bit more aggressive on particular rounds and coming away, but it is going to be a two-man fort Infused at the nades, and I think they're going to be going all in and focus on this boom shot. Actually, two sitting back at the archway and remain corrected. Excess holding that, but Craze will eventually transition to the sniper.
Yeah, Phelps just kind of run around and trying to see what he can do, but there we go. Craze with the first blood, and that's on Baghdad, and they're going to look to try and finish this off here. Toby looking very good for this for Infused right now, and Phelps in a fight up to the tower here, and he needs to hold his own unless of course he gets killed. We'll make it a 3v3, but boom shot in the hands of XS, but the kills are coming in, and Infused are going to take the first map in this best of five series, and potential two best of five of course. Like, Infused are looking great here.
Very convincing performance for their first map. Maybe a snowball effect from the Rift game, perhaps, Shawnee. Who knows? Winning a 3v4 on that first map, who would have thought Infuse would be winning that cycle so convincingly and finding themselves here. 4-2 then, the first map of Gridlock. Let's check out the second one, actually. What are we going for? It is going to be War Machine. Okay, so we've got a bit of a rematch on this map, that's for sure, since the EU Open.
Absolutely, and man, Toby, this is all coming together, really, isn't it? And you do have to wonder, Infuse are looking great, and I feel that XS have kind of missed out on playing as a result of this. As a result of waiting, of course, for this. And I think this is kind of coming together.
Well, it's coming together nicely for Infuse, but XS aren't going to be happy. They've waited this long between their previous match against Rift up until now. A good hour or two, I think it is. Safe to say, Shawnee. And they're going to be finding themselves on War Machine now. But highlight player I'm going to look at for this one is Baghdad. He had a phenomenal game against Rift Gaming.
How can you not go on board
earlier
with Hydrone after what he did to Creamy?
But, I was about to say, Hydrone somehow just shut down Creamy in the first 10 seconds of, was it, three rounds?
Yep.
And then done it four rounds, if you counted the first 30 seconds for one round. Absolute craziness. We've never seen someone get shut down so hard before they can get to their respective position in veteran teams like this. But let's check out. Are they going to be able to do it to Baghdad, I wonder? Something tells me they're not, from what we saw from Baghdad earlier, Shawnee.
Let's wait and see. Hydrone is off and going. And here we go. Straight to the middle. And this is going to be a fight, isn't it? You are right. So Baghdad and Hydrone are going to have a fight. Hydrone's hurt him. Baghdad having to retreat almost immediately. There's no doubt Baghdad's been hurt from that. That's why he's all the way down there compared to Hydrone on the upper ground. And Baghdad, I think, has recovered his health a little bit, looking to return a bit of favor over cover. But at the moment, no kills just to speak of just yet.
Yeah, it was a nice back eight to return to his rightful position. The window god, some people might be referring to him as, from his performances in recent times. Hydrone got some good shots on. He's going to get the angle on Baghdad. Gets a few shots, but doesn't lead to it down. And he is going to regenerate his health with Baghdad down, courtesy of Ash.
There we go, down indeed, and there's another one this time from Ash. There we go, getting the job done there this time. And he gets another one, Trace down in his teammate. Doesn't matter though, it will go in, infused his way. And Darkrai having to back up, does get a kill with a frag grenade. But first round for Infused, they're just looking better and better right now, Toby.
I had a mini panic attack there as I saw the nades coming into a clustered Infused squad, but they only got one kill in the end, and he's left D2 now to a 3v1, looking for a 1v1, trying to turn around as Phelps keeps his distance. But it doesn't matter. Infuse will take the first round. Very nicely done indeed.